I'm Jeremy Michalek, and I direct Carnegie Mellon's Vehicle Electrification Group. Electric vehicles have the potential to help reduce air emissions while improving energy security and offering economic benefits. But they can only make impact to the extent that people adopt them. Since 2008, we've conducted studies to understand and characterize some of the key factors that affect adoption patterns, including consumer preferences, cost, parking and charging infrastructure, range, and public policy. I'll summarize a few of our recent findings. Adoption of electric vehicles will depend on how consumers value the attributes they can offer. In one study, we estimate that to achieve mainstream adoption, American consumers want pure battery electric vehicles to be $10,000 to $20,000 cheaper than equivalent gasoline vehicles on average. In contrast, mainstream Chinese consumers are willing to adopt battery electric vehicles at similar rates to their gasoline counterparts if they have sufficient range. So China could potentially adopt battery electric vehicles at mainstream levels before the US. China's vehicle market is already larger than the US market, so what happens in China has the potential to affect markets globally. Battery cost is the largest economic barrier to electric vehicle adoption. Economies of scale in large battery factories can cut costs somewhat, but we estimate that the cost savings of high-volume manufacturing are nearly exhausted at the production volumes of today's Nissan Leaf, Chevy Volt, and Tesla Model S. So increased electric vehicle sales alone may not be enough to bring down costs dramatically. We'll still need significant innovation in battery technology. Many vehicle buyers would be hesitant to purchase plug-in vehicles unless they have reliable access to a home parking space where they can plug in. Most US households have some off-street parking, and many have nearby electrical outlets. This is encouraging for enabling plug-in vehicle adoption. But many households do not have enough dedicated off-street parking spaces for all of their vehicles. We estimate that half of US vehicles lack a dedicated off-street parking space at an owned residence where a charger could be installed. So while many households could adopt some electric vehicles, electrifying the entire vehicle fleet is likely unrealistic without major infrastructure changes. Public charging infrastructure could make pure battery electric vehicles more attractive by reducing range anxiety and enabling long-distance travel. But for plug-in hybrid electric vehicles, public charger investment is an expensive way to save gasoline, costing much more than the price of gasoline per gallon saved. A less expensive way to save gasoline is to add additional battery capacity to plug-in hybrid vehicles, and it's even cheaper per gallon saved for more consumers to adopt gasoline-electric hybrids. The limited range and slow refueling of electric vehicles are also deterrents to widespread adoption, and range may be a bigger issue in some regions than others. It takes energy to keep the passenger cabin comfortable in extreme weather. For example, while gasoline vehicles can use waste heat to warm the passenger cabin in cold weather, electric vehicles need to use the limited energy stored in the battery to generate heat, and batteries are less efficient when they're cold. So electric vehicle range can drop by 40% or more on peak temperature days in the hottest or coldest regions of the US, like Phoenix or Minneapolis. Policy also has a significant effect on adoption patterns. Plug-in vehicle adoption is strongest in states like California and Georgia that have had significant state incentives for plug-in vehicle purchases on top of generous federal subsidies. And several states require automakers to sell a certain number of electric or fuel cell vehicles in that state. But under federal fuel economy standards, states that mandate electric vehicle sales enable other states to shift to higher emitting fleets. This could result in greater polarization in the types of vehicles purchased in different regions without reducing overall emissions or gasoline consumption. So, a variety of factors will affect adoption patterns for electrified vehicles. Mainstream US consumers will need costs to come way down, and high volume production alone isn't likely to get us there. Limited residential parking suitable for electric vehicle charging may pose a long-term limit to mainstream adoption. And public charger investment is an expensive way to save gasoline. Loss of vehicle range in extreme weather regions may also affect regional adoption. And electric vehicle adoption in some regions can lead to higher polluting fleets in other regions. At Carnegie Mellon, we're working to train the next generation of professionals, innovators, scholars, and leaders. For more information on these and other studies, visit cmu.edu/cit/veg or search for CMU VEG.